The Apple Watch Ultra has been my Apple Watch go-to for the past 2 years now, and I wanted to talk about some of my favorite apps that Apple offers on all the Apple Watches and some from even other developers, as we're getting into WWDC in about 10 days from now, so maybe Apple will redesign some of these apps, change them, and maybe even bring more functionality to the Apple Watch come this fall, and we might even get some new sensors with the Series 10 and the Ultra 3, but we got a while to go for that. Which is why we're gonna talk about the favorite apps as of right now on my Apple Watch Ultra. So right now my Apple Watch is very simple. I'm using the modular phase with the Ocean Blue Solo Loop, which is one of my favorite solo loops that we've gotten from Apple, just because it's a very nice and vibrant, almost like dark-ish blue. It's not super dark, it's not super light. As you can tell, I obviously like the color blue. And on the watch face, I have most everything I can see fit for my complications. We have the date, my activity rings, messages, health, calendar, and then Waterminder. So we're going to start off with Waterminder, as this is absolutely one of my favorite apps. So Waterminder is a water tracking app that is available on iPhone, iPad, Mac, visionOS even. And it absolutely makes tracking your water intake so much fun. So as you can see, my character is this fun little elephant on the left, and it is this multicolored because I've drank some other liquids, and you can track whatever liquids you want. So I have some preset shortcuts over here. So we have milk, water, Gatorade, shake, water, and more water. And you can set these up to be whatever you want. And if you want to log anything that might not be on this list, you can just tap in the top left, and then you can sort through this list and find really whatever you want, whether it be smoothie, soup, shake, protein shake, milk, Gatorade, sports drink, and then you can just tap and swipe to add it to your ounces of how many you drink, and then it'll complete your elephant. You can also delete and view what you have drank so far from here, and you can go into settings, change your profile, what the home screen looks like, as it has a bunch of options. So right now I have it set up to be the character, but I can make it a ring similar to that of the activity rings, and I can just go in and make this truly unique to how I feel fit. Now, because of Waterminder, I've actually become a lot more cognizant of my hydration, as it tells me all the time, "Hey, it's, been an hour and a half since you last drank water. You should drink some more." Or, "Hey, did you drink something? Make sure you log it." And it just keeps me accountable, similar to that of my Apple Watch activity rings, which brings us to the next app. So on the Apple Watch, you have the activity rings. So right now my move goal isn't completed and my stand goal isn't either, but my exercise is. And if you scroll down, you get this nice view of everything that might have contributed to it. So it says your move calories and how many you have till you hit your goal, exercise and how many you hit till your goal, and stand hours. Then you get to your steps, the distance, and how many flights. And if you scroll down one more, this will show you your workouts. So as you can see, I actually have two right here, which is going to bring us to our next app. So another app that I don't always use, but I do have in tandem with my iPhone, is the Peloton app. So if you have a Peloton bike, guide, tread, or really whatever, you can connect your Apple Watch to it using the Peloton app if it doesn't have GymKit support. So this allows it to track from either your iPhone or the bike or whatever you're riding or running on, and add that data to the Apple Health, as you saw. So if we open the Peloton app, it is very minimal. It just tells you, Apple Watch setup and how to do it. And then after you follow those instructions, you'll get this pop-up that says start a Peloton workout on your device. So if we come over here and bring my iPhone and we start just a strength workout, we're gonna see on the Apple Watch that it's gonna start tracking my heart rate, and then it'll tell me on my iPhone what my heart rate is. So as of right now, it's 105 or 104, and it's gonna go up. And then we could just end this, and this will import the data right into the Apple Watch fitness app. And on my Apple Watch right here, it tells me how long, how many calories, similar to that of if you track a normal workout with your Apple Watch, which just makes using the experience so much easier, because if whether you track all your data through one app or all of it through another app, you have the ability to have it all into one app with the fitness app, which is the rings and all that, as I showed before. And now, another app that I can't really quite show you is the Messages app. Now, having Apple Watch Messages and just really my iPhone Messages has been a great way to stay connected when I don't always carry my iPhone with me, as I can quickly respond to text using the keyboard or swiping, and it just makes getting back to those people who you want to stay in touch with so seamless that you almost are always connected and reachable, which is something that's so nice. But I do also like the ability to kind of disconnect from the world by wearing an Apple Watch without having to bring your iPhone along, as you don't have to activate cellular. These apps make the Apple Watch experience so much worth it. And if you're like me who uses, some different apps, let me know what your favorite one is down below, as I think my favorite Apple Watch app that I use almost daily is Waterminder, as it just allows me to track my hydration intake and makes tracking all that information so much easier. But let me know what your thoughts are with a comment down below. And while you're down there, if you want to hit like and subscribe, I'd appreciate that as well. And I want you to remember, today's a good day to make a great day. And I'll talk to you in the next one. Peace.